It don't fit anymore. Have to shit on the floor.
Online. Je moet eventjes de internetkabel die gebruiken, want de wifi zit nou helemaal vast.
Ah, de stream is al aan het werk. Is it working? It is working. It is working. Hello, everybody. It's always a pleasure to see everybody back and the new faces. And even after they completely redid this theater, it's now getting too small already. So this is the last year, maybe in the Bali, I don't know, but maybe next year a bigger place. Or we try to find ways to expand it here. We don't know yet, but this is cozy. I like to have a full audience. So I think we're going to have an awesome, great conference. I'm doing a short welcome opening speech, talk a little bit about the past, what have we been doing in the past years, what are we going to do, and a couple of notes about the conference itself. But first, a little bit of warming up, because I want to know who you guys are. So you have to move your body a little bit. So who's here from the Netherlands? I want to see Dutch hands. That's a lot. Awesome. And people in countries where you pay with euros. Europeans, euros still. Yeah, you guys have bad luck, right? Probably, yeah. And other Europeans, like everybody, all the Europeans, including Russians. Now only the Russians. How many Russians? One, two, three, four. That's awesome. Sergei was worried that he would be the only Russian here, so. So now you can talk to Sergei and get him to code everything for you in Russian. That's awesome. Okay, and people from Asia, India, Japan, this one. Ah, yeah, Sige. Hey, India. Awesome. Australians. There must be at least one Australian. Yeah. Woo! And Canadians. Do we have Canadians? Awesome. Are you from Vancouver? Or? I loved Vancouver. It was awesome. United States? Quite a lot. Central America, Mexico, Central America. Wow, that's a lot. And then South America, Brazil, everything. Yeah, that's also cool. And then the last, of course, not the least, Africa. South Africa, everything in Africa, North Africa. There's one. Yes. Or did I miss anyone who's living on the North Pole, South Pole, or in the beautiful island? In? Israel. Yeah, what's that? That's Israel. That's Israel. Good. Other question. So who considers himself to be an artist? Artists. So, or who considers himself to be a developer? And who is actually developing Blender? Or related to Blender stuff? Yeah, quite good. That's excellent. So who is getting paid for doing stuff with Blender? Professionals. That's a lot. Or who is paying other people to do stuff with Blender? Whoa, so look at those people. You have to talk to them. Or who is from a university doing research and visualization, architectural visualization, all the visualizing guys? Yeah, that's good. Or who is an architect? And they're all Italian, right? Most of them. Or industrial designers, also a couple, right? Yeah, good. Or character animators. Who's a character animator? One, two, three, four. But there's one company here who's looking for character animators. Yeah, that's this guy, I know that. I'm networking here, so he's looking for character animators for work. So what did I miss? Some other things. Yeah, who has the first conference here? Who's for the first time? First timers. That's half. A lot. So who has the second ticket? Third ticket. Fourth year. Five. You five? Six. Whoa. Seven. Eight Blender conferences. You? Huh? Nine Blender conferences. And who's the winner? 10 Blender conferences. 10. You? You 10? 10. Me? Okay, we move on. I'm not going to talk about everything really long. If you look at the past year, we've done really a lot of good stuff. And I think one of the best things, of course, that we finished the 2.5 project. So all the developers here, thanks so much. I mean, we fixed millions of bugs. We hate bugs. We hate bug relief. Bug reports are horrible. It drives people crazy, and it gets you really like. So you want to develop, right? But we have to get those reports in to make Blender stable. So I heard 260 has some issues a bit. People were getting used to have the 2.5 series with only bug fixing for a long time. And now we added so many new things, so things start. But that's why all the developers here have a blue card. Normal people have green cards here. Developers have a blue one. So if you see somebody with a blue ticket, you can and make sure they fix what you need. You have 3 days for that only. So you can see the slide, what's happening. I'm going to talk about a couple of highlights from this list. So first, the Blender 2.5 project. For people who don't know, everybody probably might know, but we did this 2.5 to get Blender's ancient 90s architecture upgraded to something that fits with 2010. So you have to move to the future for 15 years. And that means the whole core had to be replaced for the interface system, event system, tool system, the way things are handled, Python scripting. It was really a big, big operation. So it took us 3 years to complete that. But I'm really happy that I think this year in May, we completed officially with the first 2.5.7 stable 2.5 release. It was running again, it was stable, and we were completing lots of tasks which were left over. So the add-ons are doing really good. Python, there's lots of Python scripting activities in Blender now. The new Python APIs is a really big improvement over what we have in 2.4. And of course, Python is defining Blender's interface. We could hire some developers. We started with Matt Epp 2 years ago to do bug fixing, stabilizing. Last year at the conference, I announced we had Nathan Ledbury and Janne working for Blender Foundation to do bug fixing. And Campbell is still being working for us. Brecht is back, and Sergey is now doing lots of bug fixing too, the poor guy. But he has fun as well, right? A little bit. So it is really needed to have all those people, because the quality level of Blenders and the expectations from users are going up. It's not a really crappy program anymore, so you depend on it for your daily work. So it has to keep working, and only doing everything with volunteers is not always possible. So mission mostly completed, but there's leftover to-dos, even though we are now in 2.6. There's an enormous list in Wiki of issues we still have to solve to make Blender 2.5 project finished, but also to get the user experience really optimal. We need more developers also to work on the interface. A couple of things probably people know, mesh modeling. We wait for B-mesh, it's not there yet, so the modeling has some issues at the moment. Animate everything is there, but not in the way you probably want to have it. So it doesn't work always. If you render animation, that's fine, but the interface is not interactive, or you can't use it for rigging. User preferences, lots of quips, undo, redo, history stack. It could use some work to make it more clean and fast or stable. Key maps, user configurations, color management is one of those things. So yeah, we have lots of issues. But luckily, we also have some good news to say, which is Brecht is back. And we have cycles. I was so happy. So after we did the stable 2.5.7 release, we could also announce that this secret project had been going on already since last year, that we would have a real new complete render system in Blender. Another really cool thing that happened is, of course, the whole summer of code, the salad bowl of projects. many good projects already got into the code. And of course, we have to this flagship project, Tomato, right? Sergey is working on that, but also Kier is here, the developer of LibMV. He's going to talk about that tomorrow morning. We're going to talk about it. Motion tracking, video tracking, and camera tracking in Blender. So what are we doing now? The roadmap. Everybody knows we're now in a 2.6 cycle where we make every 2 months a release. We do it reasonable. We have to test a little bit how to have more discipline in releases, not to add last minute fixes and stuff. But there's lots of branches waiting to get included in Blender, which ranges from NURBS editing to B-mesh, of course, cycles, motion tracking, particle nodes, ocean simulation, and so on and so on. So the 2.6 series is about getting everybody who's already working on Blender back involved, make sure that we have all those new projects integrated. Lots of those topics are also part of the conference presentation. Some other topic. What is the other plans for next year? This is the Blender Network. I announced it last year. We've been talking about it. All the priority of my work went to developing and getting Blender stable. So the network plans have been shifting a bit, but we started it up, I think, in June, July. I worked with Nathan on it. He's doing the whole back-end website design. I think today at 12 in the other room, we have the first network startup meeting, and we talk about the ideas and plans behind it, and also some sneak peeks in the back and pictures and screenshots and stuff. Okay. So basically, what is the purpose? The purpose is to have a part of the Blender website where we can put your names as professionals online as being a partner of Blender Foundation's network. Not only for other people to find you, but also to help people to get into business with Blender. It's really important that professionals have a place where they can show themselves, but especially on the other side, the studios who say, Blender, you know, we wouldn't mind to use it, but we want to have 24-hour phone support, and we want to have trainers coming over and consultants coming doing some pipeline crap from Maya to Blender and back, that kind of things. Where can we get support? Support services is really the big bottleneck for Blender. We need to get that business going, and I hope via Blender Network, we will get all these people around the world participating in this. But I'm not going to make that. I'm not going to set up a business doing consultancy. I want to have the community and everybody in the world doing it, locally in every country. Other plan, which was also announced last year already, but which is now running and going to happen for real, it's called the Blender Proceedings. It's mainly meant to get documentation up to a higher level. If you look at what has been done in the past 2 years in Blender, there's so many things going on. And even if you read every commit and you try that, it's impossible to understand everything. Like, how is this working? Why are drivers doing this way? What is this NLA system? Like Joshua, probably Joshua's looking, he's already being contacted. We should pay him for like 2 or 3 weeks to only write down his stuff about what he had in mind, how his system is working, what is this animation system in total, how do all the components relate, so that people who use Blender, who write documentation, really understand, so this is how the animation system is meant to work. So this is how we can test it and improve it or cooperate on it. We try to make a quarterly magazine, which is quite technical, but combine artists and developers together to have high quality end user documentation. Hot from the last stuff, everything that's new in Blender should be documented really well. We pay the developers, post it online, free PDF downloads, or if you join this, you can get it printed. So November, we can probably officially launch it. Jason is here. Tomorrow lunch session at 12:30, I think, is going to be about this topic as well. More stuff is going to happen. Mango. So we have Ian Hubert as the director. That's Ian. He's over there. There he is. Talk to him or not, not ignore him. It's going to be awesome. We are going to do some science fiction in Amsterdam. Real filming, real actors, real stuff going on, and then completely crazy. And some future with robots, of course, you can't have it. Without robots, aliens probably. We will see. We are still developing it. It's going to start somewhere in February. As for every open movie, we have a couple of targets. That is the main development targets to get done is motion tracking, mostly working already. Keying. The keying in Rwanda is still like more too primitive. You can do so much better keying software. But the whole visual effect pipeline in general, it also includes masking. Everybody wants masking. So some people don't even know what it means, but this is a mask. Masking. What's masking? What? Everybody? No, it's only a few people. Come on. So you have to do more promotion and get that masking stuff going. Most people don't even realize how it works, right? So it's good to get that clear, because in the visual effect pipeline at the end, with masking, you can solve all the problems and crap. Because nobody is perfect, but with masking, you can make it look perfect, right? So we have a great art team, already invited a couple of people to join, but next week we start an online campaign to invite people to send in portfolios, because we need many more people to come over to Amsterdam and help us with realizing the film. What is new is how I would like to start Mango, which is with a development sprint, to get a couple of the key Blender developers over and put them together to fix the Blender dependency graph. And this is what animators really well understand. This is one of the biggest bottlenecks in Blender now. There's things, especially if you do rigging and complex animation, you have dependencies going all over in your 3D environment. But also you want to have things like 10 characters being played back in real time or fast, because the whole animation system is using only one core. And most people have 8 or 16 cores at their disposal, so the animation system should be able to work multi-threaded. But we also want to have multi-time. Like in Blender, you can have like two windows, you split it. One window you could put in play mode, characters moving, and the other window is just the interface at a fixed frame, where you tweak the stuff and you see it in the other window playing. Why not? Those kind of things are very normal, in my opinion. Other 3D programs probably don't do this. I don't care, but we can make that work. And proxies, of course. Proxies. Everybody hates proxies, but we need them. So we need to have them really good, then they work. Simply said, a proxy means that if you make a big project with a team and you borrow data from others, that you want to have like the rig from Basham, but you want to have one bone local to do your own things with. And then the software should figure out for you that what you do locally and what the rigger did in his library file is always working together really well. And the same goes for like for materials. So you have your character in a library file, you borrow it in your shot to do lighting design, and then the eyes or the skin, you want to have one or two properties in this model to override the library data. That's what we call proxy. It's related to the dependency graph. Planning for Mango shifted 1 month. When I talked about it at SIGGRAPH, I thought we would start February. I think it will be more like March, because I want to have time to set up the dependency graph sprint developers. And it's easier not to have them start like 2 weeks before Christmas. It's a difficult time. Get everybody come over after New Year in January, it's easier. And then we need 1 or 2 months so we can start in March, April filming, August, September, premiere. So next year conference, we will have a short film. Other targets. Yeah, blended.org has to be updated. I remember last year we had Andrew here giving a big talk about we have to fix blended.org. And there were some designs posted, very nice ones, sometimes a bit too commercial, but good ideas behind it. I still have to set it up. But I need a team of people, volunteers, to say, okay, we don't mind helping, being the editor board of the blended.org website, and make sure that this is being updated. Like, there's lots of pages, really cool pages, video tutorials, screenshots, feature listings, everything. Now, if you feel like I would like to help maintaining a website, contact me. We want to have that done. Also, the next year conference, we got 270 tickets sold, or 270 applications for the conference. That's a lot. So officially, the maximum amount of visitors we can have in this room is 180. So we are sneaking, and the Bali doesn't know, you guys don't know. But we have another room over there. We can use the cafe, of course. And Sunday, we have another room over there. But it's growing, and I think next year, when it's officially 10 years of open source Blender, I already made a reservation to have here a conference at the 13th of October, but we don't know where or what's going to happen, but I expect more people. So the level of organization for this is growing. I need people to help. I've been doing most of this myself, and it's like a month, 6 weeks work to get this conference done. It's not that bad, but I have got many other things to do, right? I can also do bug fixing, for example, so. And then another talk, and we could talk about that at this conference, but the mid-long-term focus. So people say, hey, what is this Blender? What is Blender about? Where is Blender heading? What do we want, right? So what is this? What is Blender going to be? So, secretly, so last 2 weeks ago, I fixed the Blender website to have the Blender Foundation goals, and I changed the fourth one. So this is the new one. It used to say something really blah, blah, about that you want to provide the internet community with 3D technology and Blender in general, blah, blah, blah. So I thought, let's have that more clear. So I think what Blender Foundation's goal should be, the official public goal where everybody can participate in, is this. To provide individual artists and small teams a complete free and open source 3D creation pipeline. That's it. What? Not more, not less. This is already complicated. So it is important to keep this in mind because we have discussions like people say, yeah, but our Blender should also fit in a commercial pipeline. I realize that. We can try to work on that, but we should keep it clear this is not our goal. Because once you start accepting commercial plugins or ways that people can extend Blender in ways which is outside of this scope, then we lose this free and open source pipeline. I think it's important to have this pipeline, this whole thing, that you can start from scratch to end, deliver a film or a game project in open source. That's more important than having components in Blender, really high quality, but closed. So you have to start paying for development and that kind of things. But we can talk about it. Couple of conference notes. I have two assistants, so I'm not going to organize further. I leave everything to Nathan and Thomas. So whatever you want, they will solve it. Don't talk to me, whatever. If you need a hotel, food, drinks, but especially the speakers, of course, if you need a laptop, computers, presentation stuff, whatever questions you have, they will take care of further organizing the conference, so I will have lots of fun. The badges, yeah. So you have to put it on if you are here. Everybody has it, of course. They're cool. So you can see who's a developer and who not. But this is a safe place. So you can put your coats over there in the corridor. We carefully check that nobody's coming over here who doesn't have a badge. So you can leave your coats and bags here. There's no bad stuff going on. We never had thieves or stuff coming in. The lunch is served usually at between 12, 12:30. Upstairs, if you go to the cafe, go up the big stairs. There's lots of space. There you can get your sandwiches, milk, coffee, everything. I think we keep food there at least until 2 or 3 o'clock, whatever's left over, so you can snack all afternoon. Tonight, we have 2 screenings of the Susanna nominations and the best of what has been submitted. There's a screening at 7 and one at 9:30. Both screenings are identical. So either you go to the early screening and have dinner after, or you go to the late screening. Then everybody who's here can have a seat and watch it. This year is really awesome. Saturday, tomorrow, Olivier, is he already over there? That's Olivier is going to organize an open stage with as a theme, production challenges. Do you already have enough challenges? Yeah. So the idea is that if you have a problem, a really big problem, but preferably a bit simple, so we can solve it. In this time that you don't have to work on it for 5 years to solve it. But the problem like, okay, some kind of rigging thing, or like how do I rig a piston? That was the idea, I think, at FMX. There was a guy coming in, just, I have this mechanical device and it has to go this and with a wheel connected to it, you know, that system. Every trains have that. How do I rig it? And we keep trying and trying and trying with all kinds of ways, but it was, oh, that's how we do it. So those kind of challenges, like how do you solve this in Blender or how do you make this happen? Actual production stuff. And then we got the best artists here, put them here behind with laptops and computers, and we make a show where the artists are going to solve your problems until the 7:30 when we have the Susanna Awards. Sunday, don't forget we have daylight saving ending. That means 1 hour more sleeping. And we only start at 10:30 Sunday morning, so that's actually 11:30, right? But not really, it's 10:30. So be here, because then you can see lots of interesting stuff from Ian Hubert. Monday, starting at 11, we have Blender Institute open, so everybody can inspect it to see if we spent your money well on decadent saunas and swimming pools and everything. You're welcome. I see you. So I think that's it, my last. Thanks for listening. So, are there really urgent questions you say, I have to ask them now something? No, right, we do it later, because then we can move on and go to the next talk, because I think we're already a little bit late. And then Brecht can get ready in 2 minutes. Where is Brecht? What time is it? Oh, yeah, you have to get ready. I'm late. Hey, technical guys over there. The cable to the DVI cable only goes to here. But if you want to put your laptop here, it doesn't work. Can you pull stuff or something?